Carlos Fernandez, curator Carlos Fernandez.
Ex.
Now doctor, assistant professor Carlos Fernandez at the Goa University, a new man in a new role. Whenever I see you, I think of you as a very helpful curator of Central Library, but not in that role anymore. So you're here in the new and expanded, in the Goa University's new and expanded Library Sciences Department. How many people and what made you change?
It's the love for teaching and what my experience I've gained in, as a practical librarian in Goa Engineering College and Central Library Goa. Thought that my experience can be shared with the student and we can develop this library profession with the help of students in the coming years.
Actually, I should not be asking you this question because I went through something similar, and for 1 year I wanted to experience what teaching was. Because there we are in the practical world and here it's in the theoretical world. And in between you also did your doctorate, which I know in that sense. So how many people in the department now after it's
presently
grown?
Presently we have 5 assistant professors.
Yeah.
I am the teacher in charge of the Department of Library and Human Science. And we have 15 students for Masters in Library Science and 20 students for Bachelor in Library Science. And probably we may think of starting a PhD program in coming years.
That would be very nice because library science is one of those fields where you know higher education is a little bit bottleneck. When you look back on your 14 years now in the Central Library, what are your thoughts?
Okay, enjoyed the work and
worked very hard.
And government gave me opportunity to show my talent, show my capabilities, and it was an opportunity to work with the people, intellectual people of this NGMA or Goa. To work with the intellectuals in Goa and an opportunity to have a well state-of-the-art library with the help of architect Gerard Dikuna and our director Prasad Lodhikar and secretary at that time was Sanjay Srivastav. And latest technology was involved with the help of GSIDC and we had a lot of struggles and challenges, but at the end it came up to the best library in the country.
But you put in a lot of hard work also. I know you don't like to take the credit for that, but that's
it's a teamwork. It's a teamwork, and we never employed any, we call it laborers. We ourselves librarians involved because we were knowing the worth of the books or the value of the books and the heritage of the books. So we never employed any among our laborers. We ourselves dedicated to a profession, our library arrangement, and we used to work only for 4 hours a day, morning 10 to 12 and evening 2 to 4 p.m. with a streamlined, with a planned work, and it not a single book was missed or misplaced.
Yeah, Central Library is one of the influential libraries in India with a good collection, right?
Yeah, it's one of the best in the country with all records of post-colonial, then we have in between the colonial, then newspapers, magazines on day one, and one of the best for research for journalism and rare book collection on history.
But just while on this point, is it possible that some of the newspapers may not be there or may be missing because if they were anti-Portuguese papers in the pre-61 era or if they were pro-Portuguese papers in the post-61 era?
Might be here and there one or two missing, but mostly all papers are there, newspapers are there, even magazines are there. And there's a lot to study still, it's legally regarding the newspapers and magazines.
I see. Even those which came from other centers of publication like Bombay or East Africa?
Few.
Okay.
Not much.
Okay. Because they were not required to send it here, no?
And then it was totally
two different worlds. Different languages and everything. But tell us about your career before this. I know engineering college.
So I completed my bachelor in library science in Kolhapur University, Shivaji University, Kolhapur, and then joined in Govind Vidya Niketan as a student librarian.
GVM, that's another good library,
yeah, no? In Margaon, public library.
Very active, no?
Very active, and we had, at that time in 1989 and 90s, that time we had around 230-240 readers a day.
I see.
And there were a huge collection of magazines.
The building was still multi-storied?
Same building, still the library is functioning, yeah. And with the same intake.
That new building was built in which, 60s or?
Before, around 60s.
I see.
70s. Then I shifted to government higher secondary school library, Vasco. There I had 1 year stint.
I see.
Then I came to Goa University as a library assistant. I was 3 years in Goa University as a library student from 1992,
1992. That was in Konur's time?
It was Navilkar's time.
Navilkar's time?
Yeah, and I was made in charge of library to shift from Bamboli to Kaligaon.
your job is shifting, huh?
Right. Then I did the best and I got the experience. And then
Bamboli to Kaligaon.
So around, took me around 11, 12 months.
I see.
Yeah, we used to use the buses, where we had, university had a buses.
I see.
And we used to see
university bus, the big blue bus, which Jose was driving at that stage.
Yes, Aveline Jose.
Aveline Jose.
So we used to use this and we have shifted all the books to Kaligaon Plateau.
I see.
Then I went to Saraswat College as a librarian in 1991.
Mapsa.
1992 Mapsa. And 1994 I left and joined Engineering College Library. As a library.
So that's
there also I found a new building there, vacant building waiting for me to access.
To exchange the books, to bring in the books.
Yeah, to arrange the books and fully arranged. And when I went, I had around 5 staff. When I went left the library, I had around 20 staff. And then I got a promotion. But in between I came as a librarian of the university after Konur and went to Bangalore University. So I was for 1 year as head of the library.
I see.
Yeah, and then I got a promotion in Central Library.
As a curator.
As a curator, because all the government college libraries were under Education Department, Department of Education, and the senior most librarian was the avenue for as a curator post.
I see.
So I joined as curator in December 2006. And 2007 we laid the foundation for District Library and Central Library.
And it got ready in 2011?
2011 and 2012 we
inaugurated it. Their shifting also was a big headache.
That's what, it was shifting, a plan shifting with the proper taking care of the all the documents. The utmost care was taken with the document to see that not a single page will be misplaced.
But Kalus Bab, how do you see the library movement having grown? Because it was active once upon a time, but now not so much. No? The Granthalaya Sangh.
Yeah, the Gomata Granthalaya Sangh was very active. They had conferences and then meeting. But in between there was more slack.
It depends on individuals to take it forward.
And then coming together with all individuals. And then in between, new generation came in the library. And that had a problem. Means coming together, we had a problem. But individually, all libraries has grown. Now, if you see any college library now, if you see any public library, they have come.
College libraries are doing well in that sense, but they are for the students. Public libraries.
Public libraries have come up now, especially taluka level and district and central library. Village level, we need to study more. We need to have more. We have rules and everything, but more stress.
Implementations,
more.
What is the bottleneck? It's money. It's a costly thing.
Not money. There are few libraries are learning very well with the money what we provide.
I see.
It is
like.
It is the. Officially, I can say the management, the teamwork. It should be a teamwork.
People who are running it should feel that this is important.
It's important. They should have the knowledge of the library. Otherwise, the librarian should convince them to say that the library should work as a library, as a service to the society.
If it is seen as just something where the worst people are posted and where you do it because you have to do it, then it's not going to. But has the reading habit really gone down in public, at least? Because in our time, the university and all had much
reading,
more.
No, I think reading habit has not come down. The format have a little bit changed.
To online?
Yeah, to online. And in online, we have, I think, more readers than the what we had used to hold a book in our hand. But the pleasure of holding books will not die.
And the books also, printed books have their own diversity and their own, wealth and things like that. You can't get local books online so much as you can get in printed. So what is the most unique thing of this library, university library?
University library has a huge collection, rare collection like Pisulaka collection, Azaveda collection, Karmi Madhavada, then Nunu Vasavis collection. There should be somebody has to study these.
We were just talking with Dr. Gopa and all that, that there is a bit of a dilemma there because this is such an interdisciplinary field. It's like people in English are not going to understand Portuguese. People in Portuguese have the language learning approach in mind. The historians may not be interested in that era. And it's a very kind of history of the book is not picked up and all these kind of.
No, but only thing love for the study is required. Navilkar and Shastri had done some study.
Yeah.
After that,
I found Navilkar's bibliography very useful,
And then
Shastri. Shastri also was involved in the bibliography.
So, not many things still has to be done.
Any proposals for research on in if you had a free hand, what would you like to do when it comes to?
Now I am planning for a research program in library science.
So Goa related?
Goa, not Goa related, but libraries.
Okay.
So those are, because there is no opportunity for girls to have a PhD program. So Department of Library Science, Goa University will try for a program in PhD.
Thank you and all the best.
Thank you.
All the best.